वेलकम टू इंग्लिश डिजिटल लेसन प्रेजेंटेशन फॉर क्लास 10th इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड लिटरेचर पोएम नंबर 3 अ टाइगर इन द जू फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट बुक फर्स्ट फ्लाइट रिटन बाय लेस्ली नॉरिस प्रेजेंटेड बाय वी आर दलवी टीजीटी इंग्लिश. द टाइटल ऑफ द पोएम इज अ टाइगर इन द जू. This poem contrasts a tiger in the zoo with the tiger in its natural habitat. The poem moves from the zoo to the jungle and back again to the zoo. Read the poem silently once and say which stanzas speak about the tiger in the zoo and which ones speak about the tiger in the jungle. Now when you read the title of the poem, A Tiger in the Zoo, what do you think? The tiger should be in the zoo or he should be in his natural surroundings? Okay. And why he is kept in the zoo? What is the reason behind it? What are the reasons why animals are kept in the zoo? These questions should come into your mind whenever you read the title of any story, lesson or poem. Why there are zoos? Why these animals, these wild animals are not allowed to live in their natural habitat? Why they are kept in the zoo? What is the reason behind it? What might be their situation when they are in the zoo? Or what feelings they must be having? They are also living beings, yes or no? And every living animal, living thing wants freedom. So let us see what the poet wants to say in this poem. The poet, you can see the image of the poet on the screen. This poet is belonging to Wales. Okay, this is Wales. So it is near England. George Leslie Norris. He was born in 1921 and he died in the year 2006. Was a prize winning Welsh poet and short story writer. His literary works have won many prizes. His famous works are Finding Gold, The Loud Winder, Phoenix Living Poet series, Ransoms, etc. He is a very famous poet. Now, here is the summary of the poem. So, I will read the summary of the poem. You listen carefully. The poem contrasts a tiger in the zoo with the tiger in its natural habitat. What do you mean by habitat? Habitat means living place. Hai na? Few months ago, Navoday campus was your habitat. Hai na? Now, you are living at your home. So, your home is your habitat. What is the habitat of birds? Nest. What is the habitat of rabbits? Burrows. Hai na? So, habitat means the place where the animal or bird or human being lives. The poem moves from zoo to the forest and back again to the zoo. Here we have the description of a tiger that is very beautiful. He is walking in his little cage. He has beautiful strips and velvet-like soft paws. But the tiger feels powerless and helpless. The poet says that if the tiger was not confined to the zoo cage, he would have been hiding himself behind the long grass near some water body. Water body means some pond or some river, hai na? In order to catch its prey, that is the deer, and terrorizing the villagers. His life would have totally been different. But the reality is quite opposite of this. He is confined to a concrete cell. He doesn't pay any attention to the visitors. The tiger is described as being powerless and agonized by the poet. He is not happy. Why the tiger is not happy? He longs for freedom. Longs means wait. He is waiting for freedom. He says that during night also he is alone. hearing the voice of the patrolling vehicles of police and looking at the stars. The cage life has totally changed the tiger's personality. The poet is trying to say that animal which is famous for its fearlessness and freedom is confined and sad due to human beings who want to derive pleasure by looking at him in the zoo cage. So usually animals are kept in the zoo so that the visitors can visit and see them. Hana? And there are, for entertainment, these animals are kept in the zoo for the entertainment of human beings. And some animals are kept in the zoo because their species are getting extinct. Hana? To protect them from being extinct. So they are kept in the zoo. For some study purpose, some animals are kept in the zoo. But when we keep these animals in the zoo, we take away their freedom, and freedom is very important for survival. When somebody snatches our freedom, how do we feel? Now let us see this contrast. There is a contrast. A tiger in the zoo. See, this tiger is very furious, he is very angry, and a tiger in its natural habitat. So he is living his life on his own terms and conditions. And now here this fellow cannot do anything. The zoo cage is very small. So let us read the first stanza, and you can see the picture of the tiger in the cage and how aggressive he is. Stanza number one. He stalks in his vivid strips the few steps of his cage on pads of velvet quiet on his quiet rage. He stalks. Stalks means to move quietly with pride. Vivid. Vivid means which are clear and bright. Strips. Long narrow bands. So on the body of the tiger there are these black and yellow strips. Pads. Pads of velvet quiet. The soft part under the foot of the tiger. The paws of a tiger. So you must have seen a cat. The paw of the cat is very soft, like a velvet. Velvet is a kind of cloth. In his quiet rage. Rage means anger. He is having lot of anger. He is very aggressive. He is very furious. But how is his rage? Quiet. Why his rage is quiet? Because he is in the cage. Are you getting? The few steps of his cage. He cannot go. He cannot run. He has to only stalk the few steps of his cage. Now, in stanza 1, there are some literary devices. So, what are the literary devices? The rhyming scheme is A, B, C, B. So, you can see strips A, cage B, quiet C, rage B. So, A, B, C, B. This is the rhyming scheme. And in this poem, the figure of speech personification is used. The tiger is personified because the poet refers him as he. So, the pronoun he is used for human beings. But when we transfer the qualities of human being to a living thing or an animal, we call it personification. The qualities of human beings are transferred to the animal or living thing. The tiger is personified because the poet refers him as he. The metaphor, tiger's paws are compared with velvet, pads of velvet. So, pads of velvet, quiet. So, metaphor means the quality of softness of velvet is given to the pads and they are treated as one. Another figure of speech is enjambment. The sentence is continuing to next line without any punctuation mark. So there is no punctuation mark. Hana? The sentence is कंटिन्यूइंग ही स्टॉक्स इन हिज विविड स्ट्रिप, देर इज नो कॉमा, देर इज नो फुल स्टॉप एंड इट कंटिन्यूज विद द सेकेंड लाइन. इमेजिनरी, poet tries to create an image about the tiger. He stalks in his vivid strips the few steps of his cage. Consonants, use of S sound, stalks. Now see here S is there, at the end also S is there. Again here his, S, strips. So this sound of S is repeated. Assonance, use of vowel sound I. So here in, his, vivid. So this vowel sound I is repeated. That is called as assonance. When consonant sounds are repeated, it is consonance. When vowel sounds are repeated, it is assonance. Oxymoron. Oxymoron, use of adjectives opposite in meaning. Quiet, rage. Rage is always violent. Anger is always violent. But how it is? It is quiet. Now the rage is quiet because the tiger is in the cage. So this use of adjectives opposite in meaning. Now let us see stanza 2. Stanza 2. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. What he should be doing? He should not be living in the zoo. He should be living in the natural habitat and he should be lurking in shadow. Lurking means to move, to be behind as to wait for your prey. Lurking in shadow, hiding behind the trees, sliding through long grass. Sliding means to walk through the long grass, है ना? Near the water hole. Near the water hole means where there is a pool or a pond, है ना? Water pond, where plump deer pass. What do you mean by plump? Plump means chubby, healthy, fatty, है ना? Plump deer pass. So what he should be there? So this, there is a contrast between the tiger in the zoo and the tiger in the natural habitat. So the tiger who is in the natural habitat, he can move wherever he wants. He can he can kill the deers. He can move in the jungle as he wish. So literary devices in stanza 2, rhyming scheme is A B C B, है ना? Shadow A, grass B, hole C, pass B. A B, C, B. Enjambment. Line continues to the next line without punctuation mark. Sliding through deer pass. So the line continues without any punctuation mark. Alliteration. Alliteration. Use of the sound P at the start of the two words. Plump, pass. So the sound of P is repeated at the beginning of the two words. Plump, pass. Imaginary, the poet has tried to create an image of tiger's activities lurking in shadow. Now let us see stanza 3. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. What he should be doing? He should be snarling around the houses. Snarling means making angry sound, aggressive sound at the jungle's edge. Edge means border. Baring his white fangs, his claws. Baring, exposing his white fangs. You can see the white fangs. Fangs means teeth. This word is used for snakes also. The snakes have fangs. Baring his white fangs and his claws. He is having claws with the nails. Hai na? Terrorizing the village. Terrorizing. Whenever a tiger comes, people are frightened. So he terrorizes the people near the village, near the jungle. There are villages near the jungle. And whenever the tiger is moving, people get terrorized. So third stanza depicts the natural habitat and the activity of the tiger in his natural habitat. Now, what are the literary devices used in third stanza? The rhyming scheme is A, B, C, B. So, houses A, edge B, clause C, village B. Enjambment. Line continues to next line without punctuation mark. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. So, there is no punctuation mark after this line. There is no comma, full stop, question mark. The assonance use of vowel sound O and I, है ना? So should around houses barring his white his. So this I vowel sound is used repeatedly. The O sound is used repeatedly. Consonants use of consonant sound S. His fangs, his claws. So, the sound S is repeated. Now, what happens in stanza 4? But he is locked in a concrete cell. He is trained behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitor. He is so powerful. He is so energetic. He is so aggressive. But what happened to his strength? But he is locked in a concrete cell. Concrete means the zoo, which is made up of concrete, stones, cement, hai na? And cell. Cell means prison. His strength behind bars. So he is having lot of strength. But what is the use of the strength? His strength is behind the bars, bars of the zoo. Stalking the length of his cage. Stalking means walking. The zoo is very small and he is just walking inside the zoo, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. So why he is ignoring visitors? Who are these visitors? The people who come to the zoo to see him. So he is ignoring the visitors because these visitors keep on troubling him. And he is fed up. He don't want to see their faces. He want to go into the jungle and have his own life of freedom. What is the meaning of concrete? A building material made from a broken stone, sand, cement and water. Ignoring means paying no attention. So which are the literary devices used in this stanza? Again the rhyming scheme is A, B, C, B. Cell A, bars, B, cage, C, visitors, B. Personification. The tiger is personified because the poet refers him as he. So personification is used, his. Assonance. The use of vowel sound E. He, locked, concrete, cell. Consonance. The use of consonant sound S. His, strength, bars. Alliteration. Use of sound B at the start of the two words. Alliteration. So behind bars. So the B sound is repeated. Okay. So these are the literary devices used in stanza 4. Now what happens in stanza 5? He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. What do you mean by patrolling cars? So the cars, police nowadays during the lockdown, you must have seen patrolling cars. Hai na? When there is a lockdown, the cars are moving. They just shout at people who are moving outside. So these patrolling cars are there and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. So he can't do anything now inside the cage. So his eyes are very brilliant and the stars are also very brilliant. And he is staring at the stars with his brilliant eyes because he is helpless, he is powerless, he can't do anything. He can't go outside. He is kept inside the zoo. He want to go and enjoy his natural life. But for the sake of human entertainment, he is kept in the zoo. पेट्रोलिंग मीन्स टू गो अराउंड एन एरिया एट रेगुलर टाइम्स टू चेक दैट इट इज सेफ, टू गार्ड और विजिल. ब्रिलियंट मीन्स वेरी ब्राइट. नाउ सम लिटररी डिवाइसेस यूज्ड इन दिस स्टांसा 5. राइम स्कीम इज ए बी सी बी. नाइट ए, कार्स बी, आईज सी, स्टार्स बी. एनजैमेंट, लाइन 3 कंटिन्यूज टू लाइन 4 विदाउट एनी पंक्चुएशन मार्क. सो एंड स्टेयर्स विद हिज ब्रिलियंट आईज, देयर इज नो पंक्चुएशन मार्क बिफोर दिस लाइन 4. And stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Alliteration. The sound of H is starting with the words towards. Here he hears. He hears. Assonance. The use of sound I with his brilliant. So these are the literary devices used in this stanza. So what is the central idea of the poem? So let us read the central idea of the poem. Every human or animal loves freedom. Everybody loves freedom. No one likes to be imprisoned. Nobody wants to be imprisoned. In the poem, the tiger is not free. He has been encaged and his liberty has been snatched away. He is kept in the cage and his liberty is snatched away. Liberty means freedom. He cannot show his power and courage as he used to show in the jungle. He cannot roam around, thus he has rage in his eyes, rage, anger. But he is encaged, hence he cannot do anything and thus remains quiet. Because he is helpless, he can't do anything. The poet is also throwing light on the rights of animals. So animals also have rights to live in natural surroundings. Man has encaged wild animals for his entertainment. It is unjust because every living organism must have right to liberty and freedom. In the case of tiger, he has been forcibly put in the cage. We are not in favor of keeping the animals in the zoo for the fun or entertainment. People must be sensitized towards animals. They deserve freedom like us. They should be kept in their natural habitat. So what is the main theme? That we should sensitize people for their own selfish ends. Animals are kept in the zoo for entertainment, for fun. So they should be kept in the natural habitat because they also long for freedom. Thank you for watching. I extend my hearty thanks to all my viewers. I hope you must have enjoyed. Keep watching my videos. Thank you for watching.